The command is repeated for a second time. وَرَبُّكَ الْأَكْرَمُ. And your Lord is the most generous. Why is the command repeated? اقرأ باسم ربك اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Many wisdoms and benefits. Of the wisdoms and benefits, Ya Rasulullah, your role, your job, your mission is to recite and recite. And to recite and recite. And to recite and recite. That is all you need to do. إِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ. You need to preach the message. So you shall recite the Quran once, and you shall recite it again. And you shall recite it once again, and you shall continue to recite it. So by repeating iqra, the emphasis is given. Ya Rasulullah, your role is to preach the message. Your role is to educate. That is what you need to do. And not to judge. Allah is the one who will judge. Iqra, iqra. The point here, you need to preach the Quran continuously. Another benefit that scholars derive, some scholars say that in this verse Allah is saying اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Recite, and your Lord is the most generous, the one who taught by the pen, the one who taught man that which he does not know. Some scholars say that the reference to the second اقرأ is to the knowledge of the pen. So it is as if the first iqra is to recite the Quran from memory that is coming from Allah. And the second iqra, iqra wa rabbuka al-akram alladhi 'allama bil qalam, the second iqra is for the Muslims to read what men have discovered and written. In other words, what we call in our language secular knowledge. So the first iqra is for religious knowledge, for the Quran, for the wahi. Iqra directly from Allah. Iqra, the knowledge of the Quran. And the second iqra is to iqra from the knowledge of men. Read what men have written. Read about chemistry and physics and mathematics and biology and history. Go and master all the sciences what men have written. But realize that what these men have written, it was Allah Azza wa Jal who taught them all of this stuff. They didn't get it by themselves. Even the art of writing, Allah Azza wa Jal taught it to man. And this leads us to a very fascinating point, which we don't have time for a lot of detail. I just want to shed a little bit of light. We believe as Muslims that Allah Azza wa Jal taught mankind the basis of all secular knowledge. And if Allah had not taught us that knowledge, we would never know the rest of knowledge. So Allah taught Adam how to speak. And from that knowledge, all languages are derived. If Allah did not teach Adam how to speak, we to this day would be grunting and groaning like all the other animals do. Allah taught Idris alayhi salam the usage of the pen. Hadith in Sahih Muslim, أول من خط بالقلم إدريس. The first human being to write with the pen is Idris. Idris, the Prophet Idris, was taught the art of recording the sounds that come from a man's mouth and to write them down on parchment and to inscribe them. If Allah had not taught Idris this knowledge, we would never have learned how to write this knowledge down. And from that, the basis of writing and calligraphy and printing, all of this comes. Allah taught Nuh alayhi salam how to build a ship. If Allah had not taught Nuh, we would never have discovered means of transportation. And from that knowledge, all other transportation is derived. Allah taught Dawood alayhi salam how to take the hardest substance known to man, and that is iron, and make it malleable, and make it into any shape you want. And if Allah had not taught Dawood alayhi salam this, we would not know to this day. And so on and so forth. Allah Azza wa Jal taught this knowledge. Why? اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Your Lord is the most generous. He teaches because he is generous. He gives you this Quran because he cares about you, because he loves you, because he wants what is good for you. He's not going to benefit by revealing this book to you. You will benefit. He is al-akram, the most generous. No one is more generous than him. Iqra wa rabbuka al-akram, the one who taught by the pen, the one who taught man that which he does not know. So some scholars say that in these verses, the Arabs are told, the Muslims are told, that O Muslims, appreciate this knowledge of Allah and recite it, and then learn the knowledges of men and master them. Religious knowledge and secular knowledge hand in hand. And wallahi, brothers and sisters, the early Muslims understood this very well. This Quran came down on a society that did not know how to read and write. The Arabs were so backward at that time, so uncivilized at that time, they did not even have a script, a perfect script for the Arabic language. And hardly 10 people in Mecca knew how to read and write. And yet, within a decade, within a half a century, education began to spread. Within a century, Muslims began mastering the other sciences. And within two centuries, Muslims were ruling the world economically, technologically, scientifically. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, we've heard this so many times, but it is so true. We know the names of men who would come from Europe, from Germany, from England, and they would study with Muslims in Andalus, and they would study optics, and they would study physics, and they would study mathematics, and they would study medicine, and then they would return to Europe as doctors and engineers. Do we not see the reversal now? Where do Muslims go to study doctorate and engineering? What has happened to the Ummah? There was a time when Europeans would come to us to study even the secular sciences, and then they would go back and teach it to their people. And it is true to say that we sparked the Renaissance, and we sparked that intellectual curiosity that then caused the West to overtake us. Where did we go? What happened to us? Why didn't we understand the spirit of these divine verses? Brothers and sisters, there is much to say and time is short. The basic message, Allah Azza wa Jal, in these five verses, emphasized the cornerstone of our religion, and that is knowledge. Knowledge, ilm! The cornerstone of our religion, the foundational factor that makes us truly Muslim is to know who is Allah, who is the Prophet, what is our book, that is the religious knowledge, and then also to master the secular knowledges.